Hey, up.
Hello.
It's the ego review. Possibly the end of the ego review.
Getting around to the end,
depending
yeah.
on how we feel. And we're playing the first Gamma Maiden game maker and the last freeware game I released, Poacher.
Yeah, you gotta pay now. Yes, he got you addicted, then he jacked up the price.
That's business for you.
He's a relentless, evil capitalist.
Arts has to be paid for in a moral, economical society. That's what Andrew Ryan said. I killed all those bunnies. If you know this game well, you know I'm probably going to regret that at some point.
Also, you left one alive.
I don't care.
Oh, okay.
He's the one who will pass on the message to the survivors. I was just seeing at me 12 gauge looks in moonlight like.
I bet a 12 gauge does look lovely in moonlight.
Yes. So Poacher is a sort of Metroidvania platformer. Which, well, we'll see the plot as it unfolds, but it begins with Derek Badger, a poacher in the grounds of a country house. Because this is Poacher in the sort of slightly quaint rural British sense. Rather than the lion and rhinoceros murdering in the African plains sense.
And as in, this fellow is going to shoot himself some rabbits for some tea.
Yes, this is a sort of the working class hero kind of poacher, like from Danny, the Champion of the World.
Not the super rich dentist murdering an animal for fun.
No, topical.
No. I reckon you should be able to hunt anything you want, but like, there's just rules. Like, you can hunt anything, fox or larger, but you have to use melee weapons, fox or lower, bare knuckle.
Okay.
Because if you can kill a lion with a sword, fair enough. Like, that's your lion, you can have that one.
Well, at some point...
Those are the evil rabbits, right?
Yeah. You can tell because they got red eyes and blood around their mouths. They're eels.
So look at the blood!
So we travelled into this weird underground sinkhole that opened up.
To find Gamey.
To find the gamekeeper who was about to arrest us. With whom we have a complicated relationship, it seems.
Is this still, like, does
Being
this
out down here with sideburns the size of Sheffield. My mum was from the north. That does not explain why my northern accent is so shit, though.
I suppose it's not an inheritable trait. And who's this mystical lass?
This is Rebecca,
the
ghost lady.
I see.
Blimmin' it, this is a bit modern.
This is a bit modern is a great turn of phrase.
I happen to think the story and the writing of this game is still good.
Yeah, I think generally that and the... I think your funny little art style with your funny little man is a very good balance. I think it's probably, personally, probably one of my favorites of yours, because I also really enjoy the Metroidvanias, so I'm a sucker for the gameplay style.
I like the characters. I like the looks of the characters.
That's a bit modern. I love that. How'd you come up with this? Why fuse a funny little poacher man with Metroidvania?
Because I thought it would be funny.
Okay.
I like the idea of like an unflappable, like, northern... You know, sort of the northern equivalent of the Aussie battler.
Yeah.
Just the sort of working class dude.
The well-meaning hayseed.
Who doesn't really, doesn't seem to have much emotional depth to understand all these really weird things going on around him. So he just sort of accepts it and goes, well...
Just another day, just gotta get it done.
Ooh, God, these bats are an arse.
Says the man who created them.
Yes.
It must be the god destroying your horrible, horrible things.
I'm going to go back and eat some pudding.
You're the bed of chaos to these demons.
Oh, hey, you're back.
Is enemy respawn full tilt in full effect?
Yes, all right. That's Metroidvania for you.
Yeah.
They always come back. They always back want more.
I'm presuming health items don't?
These do, actually.
Oh, really?
Yes.
But I presume it's a bit of a schlep back to get to...
Yes.
Yeah, so it's not just free health.
Well, this is the first room of the game. Keep it easy for a bit.
How was the like layout and design done for this? Like, do you have a big piece of paper so you organize where all the rooms are?
Not really. A lot of this was done in just like the game maker tile room creation utility, where you just place tiles.
All right, but you could see like a grid. Like,
a big grid.
Okay.
And did it from there.
Because I'm always impressed how like these games don't sort of have some sort of weird gaping hole in them. Or I suppose some have, but. Look, there he is.
Hey, look, there he is. He's being pursued by evil bunnies.
And after all he's done to protect them. Are those little spikes actually dangerous?
Yes.
Okay.
That's could probably have been conveyed better with background art.
Yeah.
Oh.
Did you just save over your...
Yeah, you know what I just did? I just saved over the save that was at the really difficult boss fight at the end. Whoops! I wasn't thinking. I got my contact lenses in today. My eyes feel all weird. Oh well, guess you'll have to download the game if you want to see the really good ending.
Really? Yeah. But then the rad boss we were talking about before we came in, and Yasuo was like, oh, don't worry, I put a save before. I was like, oh, that's a good idea.
But then as we discovered with the Consuming Shadow video, the ego review is also quite a good marketing tool. So, you know, maybe there'll be more downloads of this game after this. You can still get it from the Escapist website, I think. They apparently hosted it for me.
Oh, that's nice though. Feel free to tweet slow clap to Yahtzee just to remind him of what a dum-dum he can be.
Now, here's a little game design insider info. This actually isn't water. It's just a blue thing.
Huh.
What a nice bit of intel there.
What a clever piece of programming genius. So it's like cellophane, but digital.
So the ghost lady has entreated us to take us back to...
Ghostvania.
Yeah, her home, the ghost land.
Ooh. Oh, what's that about?
It's somewhat queer.
Queer being the sort of Northern English term for peculiar.
Well, that's what it was before it meant gay. Peculiar. Queer as a clockwork orange.
That said, the word faggot is thrown around quite liberally in the rest of the game.
Sling your bloody hook, which means go away.
Did you have to look any of these up, or were you just familiar with some of these Northernisms?
No. In fact, there's kind of a mishmash of... like a dialect around the United Kingdom in effect here. That's what I wanted. Now this seems easy. This is like a sort of first pseudo boss. It's just a big swarm of rabbits. It seems easy, but if you like...
It's trickier than you think because there's a reload time on the gun.
Yeah, and if you miss one, then it can overwhelm you.
Yeah, the gun cooldown and the hop arc can... Really, and if suddenly you've got like four or five bouncing around there, you're kind of rooted.
The rabbits can jump out of your gun firing, like aim range thing. And here's another spirit being.
The Rocketeer.
Yes, and they know each other. And the compact is...
I'm telling...
The compact is where she has become part of Derek's body and is lending him power. That's what a compact is.
The power of infinite ammo.
And, and here's a black pudding. Doesn't look suggestive at all. I don't know why you'd say such a thing.
Black pudding's nice.
If you say so. I never had it myself.
Oh, no.
I'm going to take...
It's a pleasant breakfast sausage.
To keep it off that thing.
Yards is playing with the keyboard, which I think is like insanely sort of C64 old school style.
But I was using it with the controller earlier, and I didn't actually include support for the D-pad as well as the analog sticks. And I find 2D games with the analog sticks always feel a bit wonky.
Yeah, actually, that's going to be... Because I really don't want to use your tiny little keyboard.
Yeah, it's a...
Ooh, what shenanigans.
We've fallen even further deep underground. Yes, we came to rescue the gamekeeper, and now we've now it's Jim of the center of the earth.
Used to say 90 something.
I don't know if that mouse cursor was picked up by the record, but it won't be any more.
Okay, those aren't doors, and I presume that's something we can't shoot through yet.
No, torches, he says.
Spirit bomb!
Yay! It's Metroid all of a sudden. Had to go and find the bombs.
Dum, 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 dum. I do love the Metroid-style games. Metroid, Castlevania, they're great. Do you have a recommendation? Like, I've been kind of hankering for a good 2D Castlevania-y thing. What's probably your top?
Well, my favorite Castlevanias are probably the Aria of Sorrow, Dawn of Sorrow.
The DS ones?
Duology. Dawn of Sorrow was on DS. Aria was on VBA. VB. Visual Boy Advance.
That's an emulator.
Yes.
Visual. So it probably wasn't on Visual Boy Advance. It was probably for the Game Boy Advance.
Yes, I got confused for a second there. Don't tell anyone I emulate games.
Yahtzee, criminal Croshaw.
Well, those are my favorite games to play if I just want to like kill time and listen to a podcast. Because, you know, there's like grinding for all the souls is such busy work.
Yeah, I tend to do the same thing with Dark Souls and a few other things.
Yes. Well, in Aria and Dawn of Sorrow, it's kind of unreasonable because you have to pick up a soul for every single monster. And whether or not they drop one, weird, yeah. Whether or not they drop one is entirely random. Okay, now we got spirit grenades. Didn't need any for those, though.
They're piss weak. Yeah, you don't want to... Do the health items expire?
No.
Oh, that's a nice little touch.
Because I couldn't be asked to program it.
Oh, good, because it's also annoying.
But, you know...
I love the giant mom rabbit noise.
I've just cat me pants.
It's Punisher Bunny. It's the Punisher.
Actually, it's called a Bargest, which is the name for a folkloric monster from Britain, from Old England.
So Giant Murder Rabbit was an actual Old English...
Yeah, the Bargest, I think it was like a...
I can only hear Barjas, and that kind of makes me chuckle.
I think the Bargest in lore is supposed to be like a big cat or something.
Huh.
A big panther-like being, or... whatever.
There's a weird... Like, Australia has some, you know, sort of silly outback panther legend as well.
That you notice we're shooting him in the eye. And he loses a bit of extra health for that.
It was a fair fucking bit. Like, comparative to the regular shot, that's...
Yeah.
Oops. Well...
accidentally picked that up, never mind.
I don't think you'll need it.
Nah, I don't think so. I'm
doing pretty good here.
I'm gonna try and kill him with a shot from below. And you'll see why.
Makes it rain.
Yes.
We get
the knackered achievement. Mm. If we finish him off by shooting him from below. The implication being we shot him in the bollocks.
No more reproducing for you, enormous Bargest.
So did Bar-jast. I mention this was my first game with Game Maker rather than Adventure Game Studio?
You actually made a sort of action game and a game engine designed for it as opposed to a...
Yes. Because I was kind of stubbornly sticking to AGS just because it was the thing I was most familiar with.
It's so funny to me. It's like a carpenter language. Building a car out of wood.
But eventually I realized that since I had less interest in adventure game making, it probably makes sense to learn something a bit more broad.
Yeah. I think that's been a good step. You know, these.
Well, it certainly has been for me. Made some bloody money from it at last.
That's right, the spirit grenades get rid of the spirite. Yes,
that's what the blue things are for. You can tell because the blocks are blue, and so is the bomb.
I fucking hate little birds on tiny platforms.
Whee. Well, that is an optional jump, because...
Yeah, but you want the grenade, I mean.
Well, yeah.
Upgrades, you gotta have those upgrades.
Of course. That's Metroidvania for you. You got 100%.
I presume people have, done run-throughs with... out getting any upgrades whatsoever. Or do you have to? Because aren't there a few platforming upgrades you need? Actually, you'd need the grenade as well. Like, yeah, you can't.
Yes, you can't progress without the grenade. And I don't know if many people have done runs of this. There's a couple of Let's Plays, but no, skill runs or anything.
Mm.
It's not that popular. I would say I'm more into making the game than I am into marketing them. That's why I've got a producer working with me on Consuming Shadow.
He tells people about the thing you made.
Yeah, and he says, dude, tweet something today or I will kill you.
Yeah, you really don't tweet enough.
You gotta keep the buzz going, apparently.
Well, here's some buzz. Might pick up some not sales because it's free.
Yeah. Don't play this. Play Consuming Shadow. I get some money from that. And then you will be supporting my efforts. You like supporting creators, right?
Feed Croshaw.
We like being...
Feed his sparkling blue eyes.
We like being supported.
Purchase now and get some free pictures of Yahtzee's penetrating blue eyes and his contact lenses.
Yeah, my contact lenses really bring my penetrating blue eyes out.
It really, my not blue Fremen is... blue, but just sort of Aryan blue.
My eyes are so penetrating, if I stare at a woman too long, she gets pregnant. With a blue baby.
Completely blue, just head to toe blue.
By which I mean it chokes itself in the womb. So, how are we doing today?
Stillborn infants, having a good old chuck. Oopsie doodle.
Shit.
Does falling through the save hole give you your health back?
Yes.
Oh, that's good to know.
But, might as well just go up here, because there's just a cutscene, and then we'll be coming right back.
You're making me play this at some point, aren't you?
Well, if I die, you can take over. We'll do death for death, like we do with Sark dolls.
The old days. I used to go around to friends' houses and have to be physically near them.
So everyone's I'm kind of pissed off at Rebecca for some reason.
Ah, she's just ugly.
Even though the Dark Ones appear to have broken the treaty between them and the spirit people, and have been attacking us openly.
Goddamn black people.
I wonder what's going on with that. See, there's quite an in-depth story going on here.
Incredible lore!
I mean, there's all this... I mean, Derek himself is just a sort of, like, tent peg in the middle of things that doesn't move and doesn't change.
I do really enjoy the kind of bemused outsider hero format, you know? Like,
yeah, like...
I think it was a bit of that in Mad Max.
Sort of Kurt Russell in Big Trouble in Little China, yeah. Or Bruce Campbell in Eve in the Army of Darkness.
I think in Big Trouble in Little China, though, he was, like, almost a parody because he accomplished next to nothing throughout most of the film.
Yeah.
You sneaky little bunny. Like every great big American hero action moment he does, he fucks up.
Yeah. Well, that's sort of what they do with Bruce Campbell in Army of Darkness as well. Except he eventually overcomes.
Mm-hmm.
And gets weirdly competent at things.
By the third one, yeah. But Army of Darkness, I think, was playing Full Tilt Silly Buggers. I'm looking forward to the series.
Yeah, I was going to say, have you seen that new Ash vs. Evil Dead thing they're making?
Well, I haven't. I don't know if the show's out, but the trailer... I was a little unsure about what was going on, and then I saw the trailer, and it was just ridiculously over-the-top violent.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's a good sign for me.
You can't really play Ash...
Holy bejesus.
Yeah, the bar just taken over. And cunningly, they're keeping their eyes shut this time. That's because the eye weak spot was a separate object.
Can you kill them?
Isn't being spawned. No.
Like at all, even if you just fired away wildly, they're just...
No, you can't, because they're just there to block you off from going down there.
Well, this is a little bit like that Deus Ex 2 thing where you can actually like let your brother live. I was thinking maybe that...
No.
There was a way.
It's not like Dark Souls where you can kill all their headless dinosaur things in Lost Izalith if you really want to.
Are those?
Those are little blobs of black sputum.
Okay. I just call them wobbles.
They're like larvae of the Dark Ones, I think.
Good old slime.
So we've got the Spirit Kingdom and the Dark Ones who've been coexisting in like this weird underground kingdom. And they've now invaded the Light Kingdom. Coincidentally, right after we arrived. I wonder why. I wonder if there's a connection.
Boing.
So the main character that has an actual arc rather than Derek is Rebecca, the spirit girl. Because she starts off being kind of, you know, naive and trusting and not knowing what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
By the end of it, Derek's influence sort of gradually lends her confidence. That's something I still quite like about the plot of this game.
Good. A good bumbling numbskull helps her by Derek. Just showing her that you don't have to be afraid, you know? Derek just gets the job done.
Derek's not a numbskull.
Well, okay, yeah, numbskull's probably a little crueler. I think Hayseed, like, just a little rubish. You know, not stupid, but just very...
He's got common sense.
Yeah.
He's got common sense. He's not got your fancy book learning.
No.
But He's a pillar of strength
wise.
In his own way.
Yeah, he has his own wisdom about him.
He has a quiet wisdom.
Boing. Oh.
A down-homey, simplistic, quiet wisdom.
He's from real America.
Let's try not to sound too patronizing. He is the magical Yorkshireman. Like the magical Negro.
He's helping Rebecca get her groove back.
Exactly.
Alright, another wobble.
Wobble.
So,
double wobble.
What's the goal with where we're going at the moment?
Well, we're basically just trying to flee the city at present.
Ah, right. That's right, yeah, the Dark Ones invaded, so we're bailing.
Shit, the Dark Ones, and they were saying, get Rebecca to safety. I'm like, okay, fine, we'll follow this only path we can take.
This is all just Wednesday to Derek. This will be maybe a story he tells occasionally at the pub, that's about it.
Well. Ah, a secret place.
I'm trying to spot if there's a visible real difference between
them. Yeah, there is.
Yeah, it.
You can slightly
there is, but it's
see.
Very slight.
Sort of like the difference between the rocks that have items in them and the rocks that don't in Binding of Isaac.
Hmm.
There's a very, very slight difference in shade. Coins! Hey, whoop!
There is purchasable stuff in this, isn't there?
It's lucky we didn't drop directly in between those two, or this would have looked a bit weird.
Wing!
must seek the Blemen Egg.
You need to get the power!
That's our next mission. I really like Jonathan Creek. I haven't watched much of the more recent stuff.
I haven't seen any of the recent stuff either. I mean, I do on one hand love it. I also think that anyone who says that you can figure the things out is just full of shit.
I think I've seduced more than one girlfriend by bringing them over and saying, hey, let's watch my pilot of Jonathan Creek video.
Jonathan Creek and chill.
Because they usually like it.
Show me your magic, Yahtzee.
It's very enjoyable. So, they're telling us to go seek the Blemen Egg, who can teach us how to unlock the true power of the Compact.
Right. Compact being... So is the Blemen Egg like a book or an instruction manual or like a pamphlet?
Well, we'll find out. So descend into the very center of the Earth.
The good old forced movement platform. Whoa. Oh!
Yes, it's a little set piece, I think is the term. Whoa.
Isn't...
Watch out for them.
I thought you were going to get stuck standing on that. Like, I thought that was...
Watch out for them sexy spiky balls.
Would you have been able to fit the middle of those?
Probably not.
Hmm.
I think with Game Maker...
The hurt box in
this version
wide.
Of the game. Anyway, the hurt box would have just been the sprite.
Alright.
But, you know, you can change the hurt box in other things.
That's kind of nifty.
You can give
regional damage to enemies like you did earlier.
Yeah, you can put like a custom hurtbox in. Like, for example, if you've ever played Hatfall, if you've ever played the Hill Descent game, That thing is programmed so that you collect a hat when it touches your sprite, but your sprite's hurtbox is restricted only to the opening of the fishing net you're holding up. So that's how that works. It's all one object, but the hurt box is only over the fishing net, so you have to actually get the hat in the fishing net to catch it.
Some pro tips for you players out there.
There you go.
I like Hatfall. I think Hatfall is one of the better time-waster games that you can get.
You would say that.
In the Android market. Yeah. I say this as a completely unbiased source.
Yeah.
And just completely... I have nothing to declare about my opinion about Hatfall. I think it's an excellent game and everyone should buy it.
Oh, of course.
It is, though. I mean, you know, in my honest opinion, I said it to you when I was playing. I was like, I hope you're getting, you know, a reasonable cut from this, because I think it's a nifty game that'll probably sell.
Yeah, I'm getting a cut.
Are you buying incredibly expensive hooker cut, or...?
So you may have noticed the sky sort of faded in we were descending from blackness to this weird...
underground tropical beach.
Now we've found a weird underground sea, which is called in-game the Leidenbrock Sea, which is a reference to Jules Verne's Journey to the Center of the Earth, where the characters travel to the center of the Earth and discover a sea, which they call the Leidenbrock Sea, after the explorer who'd been leading them on that path. And here's some birds flying past.
Are they hurt?
Yes.
Shit.
They're shitheads.
They're quick, and they don't seem easy to shoot, and they appear to...
Yeah, but there is an achievement for killing one by directly hitting it with a grenade, which is a bit of an ass.
Those fish look just like some of the fish in Alex Kidd in Miracle World.
Do you think?
Yeah.
I think that's just what fish look like, man. You know what I'd do if I made this game again? Mm-hmm. I'd give all the monsters and moving objects and characters thicker black outlines.
Help them stand out a little, make them more visible.
Yeah. And you may have noticed there's a lot of repeating textures in the background, Art.
Well, yeah, but that's...
Well, it was even worse before I did some fixing after the first trailer was released. I added, like, for some areas with big blocks of, like, solid background, I added larger sections of larger textures, so it doesn't look just like a magic eye painting. Here's some character building. Rebecca was just scared.
So she turned to an older man.
And she's sorry. She's apologetic for having dragged us into this mess. See, the recurring theme in the interaction between Derek and Rebecca is that they take on a father-daughter relationship. Because we'll establish that her relationship with her own father was a bit distant, and so she was seeking a father figure.
magical northern becapped daddy.
Yeah. And there's no romance. I wanted to make it clear there was no romance between them because Derek is a happily married man.
Mm-hmm.
Constantly talking
very
about,
faithful.
Yeah. I mean, I think he's just from that sort of long-term married sort of...
Where it just was.
Northern type where there's no real like romance or passion anymore. That's just... They're just...
It's reality.
Together and then they can't... They don't really consider the possibility of not being apart.
Which I wouldn't say is unhappy exactly, but just, you know, it's just, a comfortable routine.
Yeah, it's just what they're comfortable
with. I like his little... Oh, now yeah, he's mad.
I like this monster, because he doesn't chase after you until you shoot him. And then he becomes very angry until he smacks his face into something.
And then he's happy again.
But he's going to be killed with grenades, if you know.
So is it a single grenade, or will, so do the shots do no damage whatsoever?
Yeah, shots do no damage at all to right. The Shellosaur, as they're called.
Just tick them off.
Boing, boing. Two saves, just in case.
Only we'd thought of that the first time.
Oh, well.
Oh, fiddlesticks.
Hey, it's another one. I'm just going to try and live and let live. Because I like this guy. He's got a good handle on life.
I have a general rule when I'm playing through Dark Souls 1. I never kill anything that doesn't mean me, that doesn't intend me harm.
So you don't kill, like, the hollows or just sort of standing around?
No. I don't kill the hollows. I turbo don't kill the girl in, what's that place called? The mystical painting world, the painted world?
Oh, yes.
I get to the end of that. Yeah. Because that's a really good place to soul farm with the sort of 300 shield globs, because they're really easy to kill.
Yeah, man.
But,
Is it because of morals, though, or can you just not be asked to get into the fight?
Oh, no, it's Dark Souls. I'm asked to get into fights. But everything tries to hit me and kill me, and that kind of sucks. And then one thing just goes, look, I don't have a problem with you, you don't have a problem with me. And I'm like, you know what? Fair play. And then I wander off.
There's a problem with grenades.
Yep.
If there's a ceiling right next to you, you can't get out from under it. Although you can... Oh, no, you
nope.
I was going to say you can shoot them directly downwards, but that was a very tricky placement of a rabbit.
I remember that, actually. I remember being upset with you about that one.
Tee-hee.
Where'd that come from?
This is a tricky jump, but it's quite possible.
We're getting into sort of like original Mega Man territory where you had to have your feet kind of hanging off the edge of the ledge.
Yeah, the standard trick jumping. There you go. Of retro gaming.
Yeah, that's a big part of it. It's the skill of a platformer.
I think another thing I'd have done if I was making this today was add a sort of texture around the edges of the solid platforms to indicate that they are solid.
Yeah, that was something that got me the first time I was playing this too, was the seeing those and not realizing they were actual things I could stand on.
Yes.
Fuck you, vomit plant.
Plants can't be killed with shotguns. They can be stunned for a short while, but they can't be killed.
Fuck yeah.
Yay.
Sausages for health.
That's why we did that tricky jump, to get that.
Oh, okay, so that was... Oh, that's good. The tricky jump's not a necessary part of your progress.
Mm.
But a fun little side benefit. More sausage equals more health. You can beat bosses easier.
Black Buddin.
A village!
Here's a funny joke that I quite like. The Blemen Egg speaks Derek's language. So Rebecca was saying that their language is mutated, we may not understand them, but they're just talking in an incredibly thick Yorkshire dialect that only Derek can understand.
Kind of like that thing in Hot Fuzz, where there's like the crazy northern farmer and then the person who translates for him.
Exactly, that very bit. What the heck just happened? There's this growing theme that Rebecca is the uncertain one, even though this is like her world. And Derek just sort of fits wherever he is.
It's like a mysteriously round puzzle piece. Just
well,
goes.
I don't know why I'm bothering not killing the zombie Blemen Egg, because we've already fucked our chances for the golden ending.
So,
oh well.
Okay, well, now that that's not going to happen, run me through it. What do we do to get to this golden ending? Why would I want a golden ending?
Well, for those keeping track, Gabriel just started about four sentences there.
Yeah.
Well, I always intended the good ending of this game to be like the canon one, but there to be like a second extra difficult ending you can get by following some criteria that no one who was playing the game for the first time could possibly predict. which were you don't kill any of these purple dudes, don't kill any of the white rabbits on the starting screen, even though the game tells you to as part of the tutorial. And that's another thing we haven't run into yet, but we'll try to explain when we get there. It's like there's these three sort of moral judgments. But if you do all those three things properly, then at a certain point towards the end of the game, you will be taken down a different path and end up fighting the Judge of All the Earth, which is the secret super hard boss for people who want the extra challenge.
He is a pocket butthole of a boss, too.
I was very much inspired by Cave Story, having a secret ending that's really hard to find and a really fucking hard boss.
Well, I actually really like stuff like that. When I first did the... When I was finding the Gold Sculptula, that's what I thought was going to happen. I was going to get some kind of... There'll be an ending thing. I'll get something, is what I thought. And then the reward was one of the shittiest things ever.
Yeah, it was,
ever since then, I've been really just bitter and butthurt about doing like extra shit for endings. And I want to know I get something for it. You know, I want to get that fluff. I need that fluff.
It was just a bigger wallet, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's fucking useless. Absolutely. Yeah. Bigger wallet, infinite money in a game where the economy is borderline meaningless.
Yeah. See, what I've always felt in terms of like rewarding the player is that the best thing to reward the player with is gameplay.
Yeah.
Or so like, reward them with like extra challenges, extra like weapons that subtly change the way gameplay works.
Or ending stuff. I love seeing
ending stuff. If you just give them like money or extra attack power or something, that's fucking shit. Because chances are they're doing all this extra stuff towards the end of their experience with the game.
Yeah.
They just want a bit more fun to be had.
That's the thing. The most you could really do with infinite money is make sure you always had like health in a bottle or something. And if you can get all the Gold Sculptula, you don't need that. Like, you're not getting to Ganon and going, So it's just such a fucking disappointment.
Sorry, what was that? Could you repeat that exactly as you said it?
I don't understand.
Oh, bollocks.
Getting hurt.
Yeah, I know. It's this bloody tricky jump. And that one RC
fucking
thing.
Plant. Isn't there a save around somewhere?
Yeah. Well, after a whole bunch of enemies.
I gotta race back to that. Boom. Yeah, fuck you, plant. Shut up.
Piss pants McGee.
You almost said Piss Pants Magritte, which I think was just so much better. I support Piss Pants Magritte.
I was actually almost saying Piss Pants McGraw, and for some reason it changed.
Piss Pants McGraw would have worked, too.
Do you want to play then? Are we going Death for Death?
Yeah, okay.
Can you, if it's on Sufferance, I'll just keep doing it.
I'll have a stab at it. Give me the controller. Okay. Can I use the controller?
Okay.
I really don't want to use the...
As you wish.
All right.
Oh, hey, I can fuck with you now.
That's not funny. Don't little... Okay, I was not expecting that to be a grenade.
Okay.
What do we got here? Okay, it's shoot, jump,
just two
shoot,
buttons,
grenade.
Really?
Well, there's three. Ba-doo, yes. Okay, got my grenade back.
Okay, there you go.
All right, familiarizing myself with the downtime between shots. Fairly long. That's one really... Well,
you can get a pickup that reduces the downtime. Watch out for the grunty piggy.
Oh, yeah, fucking... Oh, damn it.
Yeah, he takes three shots, I'm afraid.
Oh, I was hoping to get the grunty piggy. Okay, so that's
a baby Shellosaur, if memory serves.
Nope, he's a grunty piggy.
Okay, then. You're a grunty piggy.
I am.
So this is the great library background.
Can I injure those worms yet?
Yeah, you have to shoot in the head there.
Will they respawn while I'm in here?
No. If you can kill them all...
Fuck it. Oh, that was interesting.
Yeah.
Did the worm kill them? Do these just keep coming?
Yeah, they keep coming. And the worms eat them. See, this is what we call storytelling in the background. The zombie Blemenegg are all descending from the top of the library, and most of them seem to end up in this worm pit where they're eaten by small worms.
Ah, so maybe we've got like a nematode situation where, you know, their consciousness is being modified by some kind of outside agent.
If you like.
That's why
killing them is considered a morally inferior choice.
Yeah, because, you know, they can be saved.
Their minds are not their own.
Okay.
You did the same thing twice.
Well, I'm getting used to where the edges of, like, what's his name? I thought it would be further away than that.
Surprise! Hello! That's what the worm said. Hoi! There it is. It's a little, it's a little deceptive, actually. The edge of the platform when you're on narrow platforms is a little bit before you might think it is. You could just bomb the plant.
God damn it.
You made a rod for your own back there, didn't you?
Fuck.
Hoist by your own petard.
That's right, you got the keyboard. We don't need to swap. Alright, awesome.
Yay, two players. Multiplayer mode.
Have you heard there's some sort of weird challenge Dark Souls where two people play using one control?
I've seen dumber challenges.
Oh yeah, the Guitar Hero one still takes the cake for me.
Yep, it takes the entire Christmas ghetto.
It's, yeah. But still, two players, imagine trying to coordinate enough to fight like a boss using rolls and stabs.
Have you been watching Twitch Plays Dark Souls?
No. Oh god.
Oh yeah, they were stuck in... Yeah, they did actually somehow manage to get past the Asylum Demon.
Well, Infinite Monkeys, Infinite Typewriters. They managed to beat Pokemons. Like, I didn't think they were going to manage that. Well, I was wrong, so...
I think they changed the way it was done there. I think now they sort of pause the game at every juncture and have a little vote on what button to press next. Well, previously...
Can you pause the game?
Well...
Are they using some sort of artificial...
I guess so.
Yeah, Dark Souls. Like, once you're in Dark Souls, you're in Dark Souls. Pushing start doesn't pause the fucking game.
Yeah, because it's not like Pokemon where you can just move in four directions.
And there's no action.
And select options from menus. There are so many different...
permutations.
Like, yeah, combinations of moves and stuff. Bugger!
Well, yeah, it's a full action game. Like, shit's coming at you in weird ways. Sometimes enemies glitch and don't react the way you're expecting them to. I might look that up, actually. That's good. I need to see that in process, like, what that looks like.
Yeah, I wonder where they've gotten to by now.
They'll finish it. Like, that's the crazy fucking thing. I have no doubt in my mind that they will finish. Yeah!
Do you think?
Yeah.
I just get bored.
Oh, yeah. Well, normal people would get bored. We're not talking about normal people.
Last time I looked, they were at Firelink Shrine, and apparently they'd aggroed the Crestfallen Warrior, because they were fighting him.
Which one's the Crestfallen Warrior?
You know, the guy who's there when you start and doesn't give a shit.
Oh, him. Oh, the guy.
There are two bells. There are actually two bells to ring. That guy.
So they'd managed to aggro him.
Guy who's all dressed in chainmail.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, you can aggro anyone.
Oh, no, you can aggro anyone. It's just funny that they managed to fucking...
So I tried to, like, keep sort of themes going with, like, all the individual areas of the game.
That's important to these games,
I think. In this case, there's like two different paths you have to go down to open the way you need to go.
Mm-hmm.
One of them is like a more combat-heavy path, and one of them is a more platform-heavy path. And this is the Platy path.
Platy path. Yes. Everyone thought it was fake for a while, but then it turned out to be real.
The duck-billed Platy path. Where it uses a lot of these descending platforms.
Those are sneaky buggers because they speed up as you go down.
Well, yes. That's gravity for you.
Yeah.
Terminal velocité.
What is terminal? I think it's like 60-something kilometers or miles per hour. I'm not sure.
I don't know.
Big red button! Honk!
I can kill
you because you're a child.
I know the rate of acceleration when falling in Earth gravity is 32 feet per second per second. I think it's feet.
Hmm. It's difficult for me because my brain works in meters.
Okay.
I might look that up at some point. I'll look it up. That
your
can be a
brain
little...
works in... shit.
The sensible measurements.
I was trying to think of a food you eat a lot. For
poo. I eat poo, yeah. My brain works in poo-poo. It's hard to source the poo-poo
memory
I like.
Memory serves, there's a trap waiting for us. There it goes.
You have sprung it!
I couldn't remember where it was going to land.
It's kind of fun watching you play this, because... every piece of bullshit that people would normally complain about is just you.
Yeah, this is all me. I fully remember it all.
This is like your own private Silent Hill. All of the horrible things you've done coming back to haunt you.
Well, yes. What was that quote I read this week? Having a daughter is...
I don't know what quote you read this week.
Having a daughter is basically you as a young man coming back to haunt you.
No, I've always been nice enough to girls to not even bother hitting on them.
So you may notice this game has little to no menus.
I like that.
Because the game just starts with you totally in control and there's signs pointing where to go to activate.
And kind of a minimalist options. HUD.
Yeah.
Oh, hello.
It's the king of the Blemenegg. They're called Blemeneg because Blemeneg is sort of a slurred way of saying blimming heck, which is a sort of...
Huh. An expletive.
Yeah, an exclamation of the northern areas we're talking about. Them roughy dark lads have come over a mite stroppy like.
I do like the thing that just, you know, the impenetrable northern sort of dialect is also the identical to just this mystical sort of subterranean species.
Yeah.
There was a joke in the Illuminatus books about how Welsh was the only surviving descendant of the original Atlantean language.
Well, the point...
That's why it's so strange.
Yeah, the point is, like, the Blemeneg are sort of...
Oh, you got the wall jumps!
Yes. All right.
And a double jump!
I forgot it hadn't been established yet. Whee!
Pew, pew, pew!
I'm a ninja. So, yes.
The Blemeneg King gave us some, like, starter advice on how to unlock the power of our compact. And we're starting off with just the wall jump.
Is it wall jump or wall and double jump?
Classic Metroidvania. It's not like...
Do you have a double jump? Is that...
Well, you get a sort of a double jump later. Because... You get the shotgun jump later.
Oh, that's right, jump. Yeah. I was just...
Where you shoot downwards to jump.
The little sparkle graphic happened sort of as you were doing a jump, so I thought maybe that you had a jump and then there was a sparkle and you had a double jump.
No. Little dust clouds appear each time you jump. Hi, fella. You're dead.
Filthy infected Blemeneg.
Off you go.
Boing.
What?
Oh, good shooting, Tex. Splat.
Come on, then. There you are.
I know you're coming. Toodles. Oh. Say hi to the worms for me.
Well, there's no worms down that way.
Isn't there?
Oh, yeah, there are. I forgot where I was for a second.
I was very confused for a moment.
Zip-boo.
See, I like those kinds of moral choices that one could presume, but aren't explicitly stated.
Well, in the sequence where you're judged for all your crimes, it does specifically state what your crimes are.
Well, so yeah, but after the fact.
Yeah, so you could reasonably, your first playthrough.
I mean, how far through to the end until that happens?
Quite a while.
There you go, yeah. You know, you're not presented with that information before the choices are there. Sort of an honest moral test as opposed to a do you want the good ending or the bad ending?
So a lot of people bring up Andy Cap. When talking about this game.
Yeah, I see that now.
He's got the same sort of cap pulled down over the eyes and big nose thing.
Someone should make an Andy Cap game like this, but it should be a brawler.
Apparently, like, a lot of Americans make that reference because Andy Cap gets syndicated in America. And that surprises me when I learn that. Because it's a very sort of embedded in English stereotypes sort of comic strip, Andy Cap.
Sometimes stereotypes transfer, like... show called Trailer Park Boys? Sort of works very well in the Australian context because the Canadian bogan and the Australian bogan are remarkably similar.
Yes, except Canadians say A instead of can't.
Yeah. Mate.
Oh, did you see that?
Yeah, that was some goodness.
I held off going up the ledge first.
Whoa, look at this. Masterclass.
I'm the Lancashire Ninja.
Speedrun. Cha-cha-cha-cha. Fucking goddamn.
I'm doing well.
You're the creator of this game, you say? Interesting.
Yes. I must have unconsciously been counting the timer.
Stop touching me bum.
The monsters spawn.
It's just a monster tube up there.
I remember that exchange was originally a bit longer, then I thought, no, this is breaking up the flow of things too much. We're about to have a boss fight, for God's sake. So they're responsible for this, too.
It's wormy.
For that. Can you turn the volume down a little bit again? It's going to pick up the music on the recording.
Oh, I don't know. I think you might just have good hearing. It's a bit quiet. Okay, are we shooting the little dongle on his head, or are we shooting the little dongle on his butt?
Well, here's the thing. Either will work.
Oh, okay.
The head, obviously, takes more damage. You can shoot either the head or the tail section. If you shoot the dongle... You get an extra bit of health taken off.
But it goes away.
Shame that boss health bar is partially covered by our bombs, isn't it? Yeah, the dongle will come back, though.
Ah, okay.
So, fairly obvious pattern. You look for the dust clouds.
This is a very classic monster design.
Yeah, it's just lots of segments.
Yeah.
Did you ever play Chuck Rock?
Yes.
I seem to remember there being a lot of... Or was it Chuck Rock 2? A lot of monsters with...
Probably couldn't discern the difference between the two, to be honest.
Well, I think you would if you played them, because Chuck Rock 2 was Son of Chuck, where you played a baby.
Oh, okay, no, I remember that. I didn't play really much of Chuck Rock 2 at that point. I remember Bonk's Adventure.
Yeah, it's weird how there's two caveman baby games.
Yeah. Bonk's Adventure being for the TurboGrafx, I think.
Blimey.
Yeah.
The only game I know of, notably... being TurboGrafx was Splatterhouse.
That was on the Mega Drive and stuff, though.
Yeah, I think the best version was on TurboGrafx, though.
Oh, really?
Huh. Actually, was it? I'm not sure Splatterhouse 1. Splatterhouse 2 was on Genesis and everything.
I remember Splatterhouse 3. Which... Oh, now he's pooting little fireballs at you.
Yeah.
Maybe grenade his bum.
Oh, bugger.
Oh, alright, that didn't work. Ooh, oh, ooh, they come from the tail. Ha ha. Okay, did the Blemen Egg go away? Oh, okay.
They just turned back to normal. And now we've got some coin orbit going on.
It's not coming back.
So coins that drop out of the bosses automatically homing. We can get a power-up that makes all coins homing.
Which is really useful. Mm-hmm. What do the coins do? I mean, I know they come up at some point, right? You buy stuff.
Here's another father-daughtery sort of exchange. Where... Rebecca's trying to...
Pikelets.
...ingratiate herself.
What are they? Well, they're kind of like pancakes.
There's a sort of dispute on this matter.
Oh, really? Pikes? So is this like the... Because I love this stuff. I love, like, the distinction between, like, what is a cake and what is a...
Depending on where you are, a pikelet can be either, like, the equivalent of what I'd also call a scotch pancake.
Okay, I've never heard what a scotch pancake is.
It's like a small pancake.
Oh, okay.
You can spread, like, stuff on it. And eat it with your afternoon tea.
Because I know the distinction. There's crepes, which are very thin. Pancakes, which are quite thick.
Yes.
And then pikelets, to me, have always been a very small but thick pancake batter mix.
Yeah, it's like a scotch pancake.
Is there a difference in the batter mix that you know of? Should you go up there? Can you wall jump up there? Or?
Well, we just came from there.
Yeah, I thought there was a second.
Oh, yeah. Well, that just leads up to spikes. It's a dirty trick.
You bastard! Oh, those don't hurt on contact.
Will there be anyone who was great at saying the simple phrase, you bastard, as John Cleese?
Probably not, no. At least not for, maybe another generation, we'll get another.
Rick Mayall can have the silver.
He was good.
Yeah.
But oh dear God, Cleese would just draw it out perfectly.
Excuse me. Excuse me again. Excuse me a third time. Could never sneeze once. Now I'm going to snot all over this keyboard.
See, now I'm the exact opposite. I get one, like, just body-shocking sneeze, like the kind of thing that almost breaks a rib, and then that's it, it's done.
Note the little satellite dish on the top of the Blemen Egg house. Yeah. That's a little visual joke. Yeah. It's also the hint that the Blemen Egg are a sort of technically-minded race. They're probably the ones who built all this weird metallic infrastructure we're seeing in the jungle. Oh, yes. Here's another joke I quite like. Rebecca has put a sort of translation system into our mind so that we can understand what the Blemen Egg is saying.
Did you deliberately make a sort of more complicated northern dialect for the... I think it's been fairly decipherable.
Trousers full of wooshy kabang and that is what he's saying in the background there.
All right. That's pretty tricky, but I think you can discern generally from what's going on.
So this is the goal for much of the rest of the game. We have to track down the three artifacts.
Collect objects, slam them together, power.
One in the mines, one in the Lidenbrock Sea, and one in the Crystal Tombs.
No snow or lava stages for us.
We'll better raid those Crystal Tombs.
What are you buying?
Right. Time to spend coins. See, whenever I have an upgrade system in a game, I always gravitate first to the ability that increases your ability to get more coins with which to buy more upgrades. Because the usefulness of that exponentially increases the earlier in the game you get it.
Yep. First thing, always. All right. So I vaguely remember you saying some of these things, like these upgrades, weren't wildly useful.
Yeah, what I found looking at Let's Plays at least is that a lot of people gravitated to the Spirit of Peace, which sort of breaks the game a little bit. because you can just discard your grenades to get your health back, and grenades aren't that useful.
Hmm, okay.
Personally, I quite like these super powerful attacks, though. I mean, Spirit of Portioning is bloody useless.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, it'd only really be of use if you were trying to clear a room full of baddies that were below you.
And on the ground and sitting basically still.
And if they weren't like...
Oh, a lethal shield. That's pretty useful.
Yeah, shield's pretty good.
What's that? Spirit of Punishment?
Spirit of Power. Right, that's like a big laser beam. In front
that's
of
the Kamehameha.
Spirit of Punishment is where you can like drop a stationary grenade that explodes when anyone soon as someone touches it.
I'd be more thinking about what's good for boss fights.
I'm going to get Spirit of Protection.
Good call.
Which I quite like.
Ka-ching.
And this adds like the charge power to our bomb dropping ability. And we get the Underworld map.
Hey. Ooh.
Which is a very, very vague map. It's not like Metroid, where it's just a grid.
Mm.
And they all get filled out as you go to them. But it's just vague. Like the oil rig, for example, is way bigger than it's being shown there.
Yeah, because isn't it kind of like a whole stage?
Mm. And the green...
Maybe.
Yes. And the green boxes are save points.
What are the X's?
The X's are where we have to go.
Oh, right.
Where the three artifacts are. One in the mines, one in the tombs, one in the sunken city.
Is there a mandatory order in which these have to be tackled, sort of predicated on what abilities we have right now? Is there an optimal order if we can go to them all voluntarily? What are we doing here?
Well, you can go...
Porkins!
There is, like, a sort of option of which ones to go to first. There are... Some to get first that will make life a bit easier for you to get the future ones.
Is that detectable? For example,
if you get... Well, not really. If you get the upgrade in the mines first, that will also grant you the ability to shoot underwater, which will obviously make the Sunken City area much more... much easier. But it is possible to complete the Sunken City without it. That's a little skill run challenge, perhaps, you could do for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You just can't shoot anything. Final boss is only vulnerable. Final boss, the Sunken City area, is only vulnerable to spirit grenades.
Can't you get that grenade in there? Or?
No, because I need the shotgun jump to
go. Because you can't wall jump and come back.
Die, creature I don't understand.
Aw, poor funny face. I like funny face with his big, dumb funny face. Where did you get the...
Well, he'll be right
I didn't even
back.
Notice you got the money magnet.
Yeah, at the shop. When we were... We had this long conversation about collecting the first thing that makes you...
I didn't realize that was the money magnet. I thought it increased the amount of, like, shit that the enemies dropped.
No.
Oh, okay.
There isn't a thing that does that.
Okay. All right. No, that makes sense now. I thought that was, like, a second drop.
No. I think that it's just good to get the money magnet
because
it increases your ability... To get more money.
Well, it means just firing some wild shot like that, you know, getting some of the little bats and whatnot. Makes it more valuable.
You can also do the Sonic the Hedgehog 3 thing, where if you've got the magnetic power up, you can sort of make it so a coin chases you around. Just sort of make a skill run out of not collecting it. Way!
Can't catch me! but it goes away. That money goes away.
I saw someone do a sort of tool-assisted speedrun of Sonic 3, where they got through a whole level being chased around by the same ring.
You'll probably know more than I do. What's tool-assisted mean, precisely?
That's where you use, external software with an emulator, usually, to make life a bit easier.
So it doesn't necessarily mean, does it mean you've cheated? Like, is there, a cheating effect?
Well, if you use one, it's, good...
It's good form to say.
It's good form to say in the title of your video, this is a tool-assisted speedrun.
So does that only mean if it's emulated? Like, if I just raw emulated Sonic the Hedgehog into a speedrun, would that count as tool-assisted?
Probably not. Okay. But when I say tool-assisted, like, the one I was talking about that had the hoop chase,
mm-hmm.
that was done with a slowdown tool, and the video was going at normal time, but the game was being played in slow times.
I see.
So it looked a lot more skillful than the player actually was, because he was...
Because
while
sneaky.
He was playing, it was in slow motion.
Yeah.
So we found Gamey. Remember him? The whole reason we came down here.
Hey, Gamey. How are you?
And now he's pissed off.
That's fair.
Oh, no. What should I do? Oh, no. He's hitting us. What should we do? Let's shoot him once.
I hope you feel guilty.
And destroy his entire health bar.
I'm a human. That's a gun. Why did...
So...
Does it change if you let him hit you first?
Yes.
Okay.
This is actually the other moral choice we were talking about.
Mm.
A lot of people interpreted the choice for this is to just run past Gamey and not get hit. But actually, if you let him hit you before you shoot him, that still counts as the moral choice. Mm. If you shoot him before he hits you, that's the immoral choice, and you actually have to fight him again in the judgment section.
Yeah, you see, American police. Floaty lass.
Yeah. Gaming is not as good as, adapting to this new environment.
No. A bit set in his ways, perhaps, old gamey. Mm. I suppose you have to be to support chops like that.
Well, yes. Sideburns the size of Sheffield.
Phew!
I think was the phrase.
And we can't get underwater chests yet, because we float.
Yes. Notice this nice attention to detail of having metal supports, keeping the roof from caving in.
Mm.
Not here, though.
Because fuck it. Well, they use the supports from the other room.
Of course.
Yeah, Mr. Wise Guy, internet commentator, shut up.
It's like Nom Nom Galaxy, where if you've got one strut holding up a piece of land the size of New York City, then it won't fall.
What is Nom Nom Galaxy?
It's an indie game I played recently and reviewed recently.
Oh.
Where it's sort of like the 2D Minecrafty thing, but instead of just building whatever the hell you want, you're supposed to be manufacturing soup to sell.
The soup must flow.
Reminded me a little bit of Diggers, which was a sort of resource management game I used to play on the old Amiga, Commodore, CD32.
What's the CD32?
It was the CD console that Amiga made. Damn, it was shit.
I love how you... Where'd you get that? Like, was that like, mummy, can I please have the CD32?
Well, yeah, we'd had a Commodore 64 and then a Commodore Amiga, so we wanted to stay brand loyal.
Yeah, fair enough. Well, stick with what you know. Did you have fun with it? Was it a good console while you had it?
You can never ask just one question, can you?
Well, it fosters some bloody conversation. I thought have an interesting video game experience that I don't really have. Like, I played a little bit of that kind of early
PC. It wasn't
PC
about
stuff.
The question. It was the way whenever you ask me something, you ask me the question, and then you sort of go, and then you ask, and then you reword the question and ask it again.
Well, yeah, I kind of want to, I want to get something that you can, prompt some conversation. Let you waffle a little bit. I like it when you waffle. It's interesting.
Oh, look who's talking.
Well, yeah, no, I said I want you to waffle a little bit. You get to have a good ramble about your history.
No, you waffle, I ramble. That's the difference. See, what you were doing just there when you were asked the same question twice, that was waffling.
Okay. What's a ramble?
A ramble is just where you keep sort of going on and on about things that only you care about until your voice starts to drone out and everyone wants you to die.
Okay, well, Mr. Muirhart, who draws us so expertly, should keep that in mind for his next one. Yes. Yahtzee's a rambling man.
Yeah. I was born a rambling man.
Born a rambling man, yeah.
Try to make a living and do the best I can.
I think you're doing a good job of that.
And when it's time to leave here, I hope you'll understand.
Understand what?
That I was born a rambling man, Gabriel.
Oh, that's come full circle.
See, my father was a gambler down in Georgia.
Oh. Did he...
Well, he had a bad time, apparently. He fell onto the wrong side of the law. Yes, and as an eventual consequence of that, I was born in the back seat of a Greyhound bus going down Highway 41.
I had no idea you were of dual citizenship. As we're learning so much more about you.
Well, they never got around to telling anyone about my existence before they posted me in a big package.
And mailed you off to sunny old England.
Yes. This was a riff based on the lyrics of the song Ramblin' Man by the Allman Brothers. Thanks for coming with us on it. So, if you've played this game, I'm going to make a magical prediction here. There's a good chance you gave up on it in this section, didn't you?
Because is this where we get fiddly?
This is a very fiddly section. It's quite hard and quite unintuitive as well.
Shitty switches.
Yeah, because the main puzzle of this area is that the switches change what pipes black stuff is coming out of. And there's a sort of puzzle based around this area, based around proceeding through it.
Uh-huh.
That not a whole lot of people seem to get on their own.
Haha, got you.
It's based around opening up a new route and then exploiting it in such a way.
These can be a little tricky.
That I will...
Can you grenade switches?
No. Mm. You can shoot them, though.
Alright. So that area is still... Can you shoot through red? Like, can you go down through there, shoot up, and then have that bit go off?
No.
Okay, because that, see, this is what I'd be thinking. Oh, there's a bit you can get through. Yeah, see, I think this is where the black lines around the interactable parts would probably have come in handy.
Because
there's a few spots where you just, you know, like, you kind of don't know, it doesn't occur to you, you can go through that spot.
Yeah. And there's also, this room also establishes that the black slimes can flip the switches.
So one of the things, you dirty little bastards!
So one of the things that was important to me in making this game was to, I think I already mentioned, have a sort of distinct kind of gameplay for each section of the game.
Mm.
And in this one, it's this like sort of like distinct gameplay, but without changing the core mechanics of jumping and shooting.
Mm.
So this is what I came up with for this area. It's switch puzzles.
Good old switch puzzles.
And we'll be seeing switch puzzles again before this game is out.
Have you ever thought of... were there any sort of themes or ideas for Poacher that you didn't wind up using? Like, was there an unmade area?
Nothing really leaps to mind.
Some brilliant thinking music.
I did consider doing sort of an expansion for it that I was going to call Poacher Aunt Pies. Which would add, like, extra difficulty and an extra area, like a fourth item to get, which I was probably going to put in a snowy area.
So that
probably have meant slippy, slidey platforms.
Glorious.
But never got around to that. Though I am working on extra challenge modes for Consuming Shadow.
So buy it now.
For the Steam release.
Consuming Shadow will be a supported game.
So don't buy it now. Buy it when it's on Steam, when the extra challenges come out.
Oh, so it's yeah, because I...
Yeah, it's
green. I know what you've been telling me about the Steam bit. I don't know what's sort of publicly available about the
okay,
Steam.
Okay, well, it's greenlit. And,
God damn it.
Have you cleared your throat yet?
You sneezed on me like 3 times and I didn't say shit.
Oh, well, I don't see what that's got to do with you being a coffee bastard. Unless I gave you a disease.
That's possible. So, yes, it's been greenlit.
Yes, it's been greenlit. And while we thought... For the occasion, since it got greenlit in like 10 days and we're all really chuffed.
Thanks for the support, community.
Yes, thanks, community.
Take that, Steam, for not just greenlighting on your own.
Yeah, and fuck you, good old games.
For just ignoring it altogether. You heard it here first. Where are we going now?
I've forgotten what I was supposed to be doing.
Because, okay, the only area we haven't been is to the left.
Yes.
So,
okay, yes, I remember.
We need to find where this.
So, what we need to do is drop that shit. And now that we've opened up an alternative way to get there, we can go back that way.
Ah, yes. Backtrack and come down through.
Yes. Right. Well, I might just save again and get that health back.
Always does the body good.
Yes.
So, yeah, it's greenlit. Yes. So what's the process from being greenlit?
Well, it's greenlit and, well, basically we can release it when we want, but...
You want to wait until you've got...
Yeah, I wanted to add some extra gameplay, some extra challenges, to you know, since we've proved it's got support.
Will the Humble Bundle folks get access to any of this?
Yeah, I think so. What we've... It's just like a new version to mark the new release.
Alright. But yeah, but I mean, people who've already bought, like, the...
Just to create an extra bit of buzz. What we found was that once you'd, like, finished the... Like, got the A ending with all the characters... Mm-hmm. Wasn't really much more you could do besides unlock all the monster bios and stuff.
Which is kind of interesting.
As we were saying, challenge is the best reward.
Mm.
Gameplay is the best reward. So we're going to add like special modes that add special modifiers to things, like where you can't buy ammo from shops. Or modifiers like...
That's when you got to use the fisticuffs.
Like a modifier that I quite like the idea of, where you can't refill the med kit. So you only have the med kit you start with.
The med kit, are you going to mod the how much the med kit is used per like time? Because it kind of goes at a bit of a rate. Like basically you're only getting one refill and that's about it.
Yeah.
One. Oh, shenanigans. Oh, fiddlesticks. Okay, so the oil produces an actual wall you can't nuzzle through even if you're hurt and flickering.
Well, you can glitch your way through it, yeah. But it takes a bit of doing.
Oh, that's right. I remember you telling me something about that. Someone had figured out how to just glitch your way through the oil and basically gimp
a big
portion
of the section.
Yeah, that
was the way people seemed to go if they couldn't figure out the actual puzzle.
Can't figure the puzzle. Fuck it. I'm going to just mess with the game.
Well, why not?
Yeah. Get through how you get through.
And yeah, so we're also adding like an infinite mode, like infinite dungeon mode, like more like monsters and more special kinds of monsters with special modifiers to make them slightly harder.
Oh, cool.
So a bunch of variety and
the piddler
and some stuff. Something to look forward to once we've done that. Don't really have a time frame on that yet.
The tickle monster.
But, you know, hopefully soon. But I'm also having to do some like work on Hatfall as well at the same time. Like some extra content for that as well, coincidentally. Not that I want to get stuck making the same two games the rest of my life. Hoping to sort of draw something of a line after them after all this. I know. It might be fun to do additional update content updates every now and again.
Oh, yeah, you know, reinvigorate interest in the...
Yeah, get a bit more of the buzz going. Maybe wait 20 years, get the nostalgia appeal.
All right. HD re-releases on the PlayStation 12. Well, which is just an implant that goes into your brain then.
I think we'll be beyond HD by that point. We'll be on VHD.
We'll be on Better Than Life. You can Better Than Life and you can actually play as Yahtzee designing the game.
That would be a weird
It would
experience.
Be terrible.
Get ready to spend the whole game pacing around the room. this last room in the oil rig is like the culmination of everything we've learned.
Oh, little balls. So we're trying the object of our desire. Yes. Oh, there it is. We got it.
Had to hit all the switches to make all those oil pipes stop offloading.
So many little fucking flingers.
And collect a thing.
Hey.
A spirit tablet that Rebecca can read. Teamwork, is it?
Ta-da.
Now, in the original version of the game, when you launched a bomb, it just came out of you. But then I realized I wanted to emphasize, as part of the plot, the partnership between Derek and Rebecca.
That the mystical components would have to be Rebecca.
Yeah, so whenever you launch a grenade or use the other powers, Rebecca comes out to do the handiwork.
I think that's good, too, because it also modifies the angle of the grenade slightly. You know, it gives... So, like, the roof thing. Like, yeah, the grenades are useful, but if you've got a roof over you, like directly over your head, ooh, suddenly can't use them, so you got to start thinking a bit differently.
Bam!
Ah, so you got down grenades now.
Well, we always had those.
Oh, okay.
In fact, here's a thing that's... Oh, wait till I'm in a better place to do it. There's a thing not many people picked up on called shotgun juggling, where it is actually where your grenade gets an extra bit of bounce if you shoot it from below. And if you shoot a grenade directly upwards... You can shoot it again and juggle it.
So you can shoot your own grenade and get more range?
Yes.
Huh.
Well, if you want to range, you could just shoot it forwards. It's pretty much a useless ability.
It's a show-off.
Yeah, it's not a good place to do it.
There are no good places. Everything is sad. You'll need one of the big chasm-y open rooms again. I think this has got too much fiddly architecture about to...
Right, well, we're done with the oil rig. Hooray!
Huzzah.
Now we have the ability to sink in water.
Oh, okay. So that's off to... Well, now we still run out of air, don't we?
Well, we could do the undersea area. But, like I said, it'll become a lot easier if we acquire the ability to shoot underwater first.
See, that's interesting, because I suppose if I went underwater now and tried to shoot, and then I'd be like, oh, okay. Maybe not do the underwater bits just yet.
Secret.
I forget, you can swim just by pushing jump, right?
Now. Way, yes, and it makes a lot of bubbles appear.
Bloop, bloop, bloop.
On some systems, going underwater and jumping all over the place is what we call slowdown town. Because every bubble is like an individual in-game object.
Ah, did that happen with this, or did you find a sneaky way around it?
No, I was always fine. But I've seen some people's like video gameplay videos where it slowed down a bit when you go underwater.
Is there anything really... I mean, I suppose you could tackle that underwater level, but probably more prudent to shoot.
That the wall jump combined with trying to jump out of water is a bit of an arse, it must be said. Okay, fine, we'll just go this way.
Fuck it! Change my mind! Doing it a different... You can... Fucking birds. I don't like those birds because I know they come across in ways that don't necessarily line up with the gun and can be just sort of like a millimeter below it.
You come across in a lot of ways, don't you?
Yes. And sometimes up and down.
Yes.
We're
going to the save point. And then I can demonstrate shotgun juggling, because we're in the open air.
Ah, huzzah.
So you just go... Whoop. Oops. Shit.
Okay, that looked like it should have hit. Maybe it is hitting, but we're not seeing it.
So. It should be a... Okay.
Okay, I'm missing. You're missing it by
like... Okay, I keep buggering this up. I did it before, really.
I promise you. You gotta move forward a bit more. Hey, there it is. Look at that.
That's how you do it.
Is there an achievement for like...
There is. There's an achievement for shotgun juggling three times. Now, it'd probably be easier if we had the upgrade that increases your reload time. Decreases, rather.
Yeah. It is fuck shit slow at this point. Okay, so where are we going now? We've done... There's the map.
It could even be a slow shit fuck.
Spirite mines. That's probably where we should go next.
Yes, we're going through Webweave Forest.
And I wonder if there are spiders in there.
What gave it away?
I don't know. I think I actually have psychic abilities.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
You're just Webweave. A big twat.
I'm going to use my Professor X-like abilities. Gene! So, okay, Webweave...
Yes.
...is... That's not the area where the tablet is, though.
No, that's the way we... That's just what we have to go through to get to the mines.
Is there a boss in Webweave? Because I realize now the oil thing doesn't have a boss.
Well, unless you count the final room. Now, there isn't a boss in Webweave. Webweave is just a transitionary area.
Okie dokie. Goofy face.
Yes. He never ceases to please. Okay. So you'll note every time we go to a save point, it's the same sort of terrain. Weird sort of cyan bricks. And most of the save points don't really transition to it, but that one does, for some reason.
Because you remembered to do it.
I'm just pew, making pew. Words come out of my mouth.
Face hole.
So we couldn't have gone up here without the wall jump.
Eat it, little piggy.
And here we find...
Oh yeah, the tea lady.
The first tea lady.
Ooh, ducky booze.
I'll drink some of my tea while we're here.
His nest tea.
It's Lipton, actually.
Oh, it's Lipton, okay.
This is where we'll establish the plot. Like
exposition!
The backstory of this whole underground kingdom. Which will become relevant once we've read all of it. So yes, the spirits and the Blemeneg were all descended from the same common ancestor as humans. They all went down to the Undercity, the Underworld, to form the Great City.
You can be happy underground. And then disaster struck.
Yes.
Was it a race war?
That's what we call a cliffhanger.
Mm.
Actually, it wasn't.
Oh. No, tell me now. Oh.
Pew! Yes, the Blemeneg mystical shamans are...
Mystical old tea ladies.
Slightly infuriating bunch.
With a little Batman skedaddle.
Oop. Fucking bunnies. In many ways, the bunnies are one of the biggest bugbears in this
fucking
game.
Bats.
Bug bunnies, rather.
The fucking bats drive me insane, because a lot of the time you sort of don't spot them.
So we couldn't have gone down here without the ability to sink in water.
Are there, like, air sources, like, underwater, like a bubble or something you could bump into?
You just saw me pick up a bubble.
No, I didn't. I didn't even notice.
Well...
No, there we go. Okay.
You're still not paying attention, I see.
Well, no, I think... Because, okay, see, now I know that those wiggly things are, like... Ooh. Yeah, how does the light get to them? What do these trees run on?
Culture clash. Well, I guess they've evolved to run on something other than sunlight.
Bunny farts.
Mind you, there seems to be plenty of light in this area.
Yeah. Maybe there's like phosphorescence.
Maybe there's a million.
Oh, you sneaky beggar!
Glued to the ceiling.
Is that shootable rock? Nope.
Nope.
I heard a ding.
Yes, there's a dingy thing off-screen to the left. Yes, it's more shooty switchy puzzles. This is establishing that you shoot those target things to make those ledges swap from. One way to the other.
Good thing you brought your shotgun. Fucking goddamn spider things.
Yes. Fuck you, goddamn spider things. Player training, very important. You gotta introduce a new mechanic in with a nice simple area.
Gently ease people in.
Introduces all the different applications.
Yo-yo spiders.
And also some spiders.
What do the blue ones do?
Besides, need to be killed with bombs.
Oh, okay. So
well, the green ones only descend when you're nearby. The blue ones descend, go up and down constantly. That's the different hunting strategies. It's like the trapdoor spider versus...
an orb weaver.
This is a shitty spider that is not very good at hunting.
Dumb spider.
Wee! Get in my mouth! Get in my mouth! Get in my belly!
There's a spider that weaves, like, webbing between its sort of adapted giant long front legs.
Are we talking about the gladiator spider?
Yeah.
Yes, I've seen them.
That's nutty. Spiders are nuts. There's ones that, like, weave little diving bells around their heads and live underwater.
So Magnus has a little arc here as well in this game. Magnus starts off being, like, protective and dismissive of his sister, and gradually starts to, come to terms with the fact that she's more powerful than him.
The compact has made them stronger than you could ever imagine.
And he sort of works that into his tactical ability later.
He'll send his sister and the mad northerner after...
Derek's not mad.
Well, to them. I'm saying, you know, from his perspective, Derek could be a mad northerner.
Well, no. He's not a northerner.
What's that drawing?
He's a surface dweller. It's a sort of cave art that's allowed us to learn a little bit more about compacts, like we've learned about the shotgun jump. Oh, look. Stuff.
Guy shooting woman.
There was a chest down there. So, yes, there's no way of getting back up here by wall jumping. You have to use the shotgun jump.
Yeah.
Yeah, the double, having to do this, having to press down and fire to do the shotgun jump is very fiddly with the analog sticks, I find.
I've gotten a little better with it, just playing a few of the modern 2D platformy little indie things with the stick. I just can't do it on the keyboard anymore.
I tend to use controller for most games these days.
Is it perhaps because you did all the playing?
Boing.
Hey, oh, now we have Boing. Access.
Now we ascend. Like a boss.
Saves, yes.
Mobility.
Safety.
Mobility's great.
Yep, one of the most important things in Metroidvanias.
I need to take over a bit because I need a wig.
Well, I don't need the... I have the...
Oh, okay.
Okay, I'm back in a sec.
Try not to be bored to death. Listeners.
That's okay, I'll probably die a couple of times. Boing, jump. Okay, so we've got that. Need to refamiliarize basic jump. Okay, back on foot. Alright, a little bit wobbly there. Alright, we can go through here. Okay. That double jump was unnecessary. Hey, up! Let's see. Yotsi and I have been going indoor rock climbing a lot lately. I sprained my ankle at the last one. Not doing anything really thrilling or even interesting, I was doing the bouldering things. Climbing across, I stood off after a very successful journey and stood in the little hole that they have for the bolts to put the belaying things in. And I sprained my ankle. So I've been limping about like a T-800 that just thinks it's saw Sawyer O'Connor. And I haven't been able to do climbing. Which is kind of a shame. Because, A, it's when Yahtzee's actually happy, which is sort of pleasant. Aha, I got your fucking bullshit, Kershaw. And B, it's actually really good exercise, and I'm getting better at it and dealing with my horrible fear of heights. I'm able to do the challenging courses now. Okay. Oh, figs. Oh, alright, no, I need that. Oh, can't see, bum in the way.
Wake up, listeners, I'm back now.
Oh, now I'll have to wait. Okay, ding.
I heard you telling all the listeners about how much of a pussy you are, still stuck on the easy climbs.
I'm not doing the easy climbs, I'm up to, like, some of the more challenging ones.
Yeah, the more challenging easy climbs.
Yeah.
Like, you started off on the yellow climbs, which is the easiest baby climbs. Like,
yeah, it's just one hand over the other.
Like, one
of
them,
that's right, I can't shoot them to death.
One of them has numbers on the wall. So you can also learn
fiddles.
You can also learn counting while you're climbing.
Well, again, like the primary reason I do the indoor rock climbing isn't for the sort of sport itself or for the fitness aspect. Well, I mean, I do enjoy that, but to get over my fear of heights. Which I think I've been...
But you moved all the way up to purple now, haven't you? To purple climbs, which are the second easiest.
Oh, that's map.
Out of eight colors.
The black ones are ridiculous. Like...
We are transitioning from blue to green at present, which is sort of like easy medium to medium. But the green, I find, requires a sudden advancement in grip strength.
Which Crowshaw does not have.
Well, I do have long fingers.
That'll come in handy.
Your shit!
Well, I got Piggy.
Well done.
Okay.
Ha ha ha, it's not as quite as easy as that. Gotta get past Mr. Spider.
Keep fucking pushing map instead of now. Oh, piss midgets. Aha.
Yeah, I see we've evolved past figs. We've gone all the way up to piss midgets now.
I'm looking forward to when we have the quick reload.
What is a piss midget?
It is the European equivalent of a urine dwarf.
They're like a squish mitten.
Shouldn't I have been able to get through that?
No.
Okay, that looked like a...
You can stand on the light green bits, not on the dark green bits.
Push down and jump. God damn it. There we go. God damn it. If I can reload faster, you goddamn northerner.
So the tongue of me for a second there. My friend Praz likes to give me shit about being from up north, despite the fact that I'm from the Midlands. Because he's from London.
I was gonna... Yeah, you guys have the England thing going.
And to Londoners, anything north of London is up north. I would hypothesize that perhaps there could be an area in between north and south.
The Midlands?
In the middle, yes. That perhaps we could refer to as the Midlands, as indeed we do.
So he used to grief you.
Yeah, well, that's prayers for you.
Yep. Okay, that probably wasn't a necessary skill shot I just made there. Oh, don't have any grenades left. Kind of a shame.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, I needed to time that one better.
Yeah. Okay, I got it. Are these universal, the amount of time they take?
Yeah, that's what the blinking is for.
Right, so it's five.
Three blinks, and then it's back. You gotta keep your eye out. One, two, three, and back. There you go.
Pro.
Your mummy's big boy now.
I'm the big boy. Give me some bacon, Porkins. Come on, I just need some of that sweet health. Shit.
How are you liking this background art, viewers? It's a load of colourful shapes.
Well, shit.
What are you gonna do now? Die, apparently. Horribly.
I was like, just hold out, Flicker. Just hold out.
All right, now the... as Tony Abbott once said, now the grown-ups are back in charge.
It's appropriate, given that you're now wearing a Speedo.
Hey. I like to air out my thighs in the afternoons.
They do need an airing. It looked like there was something that down... Shouldn't that be hitting them?
I was just wondering that. Hey, Mr. Spider, I'm just going to be neighborly.
Live and let live. Take only pictures, leave only footprints.
And sweet wrappers.
Maybe a dump or two. Oh.
And here we are.
Yep. Alright, back to my point. You're better with those grenade arcs.
Yes. Oh, hey, I think I pissed him off. Oh, I wonder what this platform signifies.
Ah.
A secret place, of course. Spider did that on the first go, actually.
Yeah, that would have been...
It's really tricky timing, that one.
I don't have a lot. That would have been helpful in my quest against the spiders.
Yeah, the... pickups don't land on narrow platforms. That's sort of a limitation of the engine, really. Oh, bollocks. Oh, double bollocks. Double bollocks and fries.
That'd be $5.95.
That's what we call Scottish chip shop.
He didn't have any money.
No, I just absorbed it all before you saw it. Because the money recognizes me as its king.
I'm emperor of money.
Thought that was Donald Trump.
He's a fun nugget to watch.
Well, he won't be if he becomes the president. Then he'll, like George W. Bush, be unspeakable terror among all non-American countries.
Bush will be like, oh man, remember George W. Bush? He was great. Like, that's what he'll be compared to Trump.
Yeah.
I love, America's my favorite show on the internet, man.
At least he didn't start a war with Mexico.
Great society you got going there. Ooh.
I think America is what we see when an entire society collectively wants to die.
Just euthanize it. I wouldn't go that. It's to me, it's a place of contrast. Like, so much that I absolutely love and adore is produced in the United States, and at the same time, it is a concentration of an awful lot that I absolutely abhor. Ooh, up. Oh, now the timing's getting tight.
Tis indeed.
There's a fucking Porkins there. That sucks.
Yes. And I'm only on one bit of health. What an arse.
Yeah, you're not going to be able to tank that. Die.
He did. Well done. Thanks for contributing.
I have the power of the word.
The word of God. Like in that comic book.
With the Phil's self. Word, oh God. That's a bit of a toughie.
Yeah, I'm confused for a second. Let's talk about something. This is going to be going for a while.
Normally we have questions up.
Yeah, I forgot. Let's think of a topic from the world of gaming. Konami are shit.
Yeah, that's an interesting thing to watch. What's going on there? Because I've sort of tuned out on a lot of it, really.
Well, they've sort of given up on all their gaming franchises except to make pachinko machines out of them.
Yeah, that seems to have also happened. The company that produced the King of Fighters games has been bought by a Chinese company and appear to be now focusing on pachinko. Because apparently those things make fucking bank.
What is it with pachinko? Is it like the pokies in Australia?
Yeah. Apparently, like, that's from what I can gather, it's just like Asian pokies. And if you can get, like,
Did you see that?
Yeah.
That was quite acrobatic.
If you can get even a small amount of China playing those things, you've made a ridiculous amount of money, so... Here's hoping they sell. Apparently China's getting into them now. That was something I read for this. That was why this company... Like, that was in an article I read about this company was, we're going to... Apparently there's even King of Fighters pachinko machines, which is, as a fan of the series of fighting games, somewhat depressing.
Haha.
I have a send and a save. All right.
Yes, I was touch and go for a while there.
I remember the fucking mines.
Good thing we picked up that one health.
Achoo!
Yorkshire pudding. So now this is more shooting targets, but with slightly different rules. Now we shoot the green and red things to toggle walls. So we shoot that green thing and that wall deactivates. Now the reason why the platforms spin every time they reach a corner is because when I tried to make the game, I noticed that the character would always fall right through the platform every time the platform changed direction.
Huh.
Because, again, limitations of the programming.
A weird clipping issue. So now it's a trap.
Yeah, so now we pretend it was a feature all along. Hey, look, it turns at the corners.
That means you have to get off.
Yes. And that switch I shot over there was a secret switch that opened up this area.
So I've heard Konami's an awful place to work for and stuff like that. So I've heard some horror stories. I don't know how,
I understand what we found out about Konami was fairly common for a lot of Japanese companies.
So for myself and maybe a few, people watching who aren't fully aware of it, maybe take us through what you know of the...
That's all I know.
Oh, all right. Well, that was fun. This is Yahtzee and Gabriel sum up the news for you. Konami's kind of shit, but then so is most of Japan.
Just heard it was a bit shit and that their practices are fairly common in the Japanese industry. So here's the second secret tea lady. We need to get all of these to find the good ending.
So do you think...
Did I mention that?
No, I did not.
Well, you do.
Well, we do. All right, good to know.
So the disaster that was mentioned last time was an earthquake. And the great city was destroyed by floods. That's why there's a sea at the bottom of the... in the center of the earth.
Uh-huh. Okay, so...
Yes.
Oh, maybe his name's gone. You know, made Metal Gear Solid.
Hideo Kojima.
Okay, so do you think the name Kojima can sell, or the name Metal Gear Solid will sell better? Because if Kojima comes out with like some new game that's kind of like it, but not Metal Gear Solid, do you think he'll get enough people jumping ship and sort of abandoning Konami's productions? I mean, fuck it. Let's just speculate here. We're talking now. Magic. We have the power of sight.
I don't think you can realistically separate Metal Gear Solid from Hideo Kojima.
I wouldn't have. I think anyone who's going to be doing any more games of that is going to have to be aping his style fairly.
I don't think they're even going to bother, man.
Probably a good idea. So that means we'll get,
Well, we'll get the Phantom Pain in September, and that'll be your lot.
Oh, there we go. I think that's probably a good thing. You know, let it end, let Kojima maybe wander off on his own and crowdfund some weird indie project of his own.
I heard Microsoft were trying to get their hands on Silent Hills. It'd be nice to actually finish whatever the hell they'd started there.
Were you a fan of the promotional material that came out for all that?
You mean PT?
Yes.
Well, you know, that was really just a proof of concept, wasn't it? I mean, it doesn't really reflect anything on the finished game.
No.
I don't know, I mean, clearly they had a lot of cool, surreal imagery. But Silent Hill is kind of more than that.
Mm.
I mean, they're just sort of non-specific fucked up imagery. When, if you look at Silent Hill 2 and 3, all the fucked up imagery is sort of like evoking something.
As opposed to just scary, kind of like, the ring girl crawling after you.
Like all the monsters in Silent Hill 2 evoke violence against women. Because that's the hidden theme. Because the hidden theme of the game is male sexual frustration.
Secrets. And corgis controlling the world. Haven't we been here before?
Yes, but there's a save point.
Uh-huh.
Yes, this is where the world circles around. It's always nice to have that in a game. A Metroidvania game, I think.
You pop out that little bit you couldn't get to earlier, and you're like, puzzle complete.
Yes. Try not to pop out your little bit in mixed company, though.
Out it comes.
I amuse myself.
Oh, you go through the door, spider, you sneaky bugger.
Oh, what an ass. Now, here's a case of something that could end badly if you don't think ahead. Yeah.
Seems fine. Oh.
I mean, I'm sure one could reasonably predict that was going to happen.
Are any of the spikes like insta-deaths? Like, kind of Mega Man style.
Not here. There are some insta-deaths in the game, but the spikes aren't.
What are we going to find them? You know, okay, I suppose pits. There'll be a few pits.
This is where the gradual deletion of blue blocks becomes a gameplay mechanic.
Pew!
When you're ready.
Well, I mean, you know, I don't think Kojima's going to be wanting for... If he went on to Kickstarter,
about this conversation. If he just went on there and said, "Hey, I want to make a new game.
I want to Kojima it up. Help me out here, people."
I mean, it is slightly confusing that he is so popular. I mean, the Metal Gear Solid games were never exactly the most... what's the phrase to use here? Conservatively designed games?
Do you suppose it's just their place in history? I mean, you know, Metal Gear Solid 1 being kind of a really big PS1 release and sort of being a big part of that early 3D era.
I think it continued to get by with its sort of spectacular awfulness.
Maybe a little campy value to it?
Here's a tricky puzzle for getting a health upgrade. You have to use your spirit grenades artfully.
Turning it off. Nope. I presume there's a... you need a certain amount of spirit grenades to even get through here.
Yeah.
Ooh. Get that one.
I think this is still doable.
You can get a boosty off the edge of that one above you, then.
If I can get a wall jump off.
Can you shotgun jump, wall jump, shotgun jump? Oh. Yeah! Sausage.
Just call me the man.
Okay.
The Yorkshireman.
Because, I mean, I'm, you know, I'm actually looking forward to Shenmue. What did I say? When what's it?
Shenmue 3, were you about to say?
Oh, no, but when Duke Nukem Forever came out, I was like, this is the end of games being over. I can now start daydreaming about, like, Shenmue 3. Is it Shenmue or Shenmue? I've heard, like, both pronunciations, and I'm not...
Well, considering sure. It's Japanese, it's probably Shenmue. Shenmue.
Shenmue!
Because when they had, like, these two vowels
Shenmue.
In Japanese pronunciation, as far as I'm aware,
all right.
It sort of...
Somebody tweet that to me, I'm curious. I'd like to know the pronunciation of Shenmue.
Shen... Well, I can... I'm willing to bet it's probably not Shenmue.
Well, yeah, I wasn't really aiming to get the correct pronunciation out there. I was going with the one that I traditionally
Shenmue,
use.
Shenmue, the Chinese cow. Damn it, Shenmue. Stop charging backpackers.
Don't give me that tone.
Oh, I can't stay mad at you, Shenmue. Stop using karate cow skills.
Cowrati.
Now what we have to do here... is spirit grenade that, shoot that, and hopefully not fall on the spikes.
And that was some close.
That was a tricksy one.
Nice to see you've ladled out a few spirit bombs just sort of around.
Yeah, because otherwise
it'd be bullshit.
If you got as far as this room and run out of spirit bombs, you weren't going any further, were you?
Got to keep those dead ends from showing up.
Huh, a conspicuous save point.
How long have we been talking?
Holy shit.
What?
Hour and a half.
Jesus!
And we're...
I don't think we're close to the end, really.
No, we're not close to the end. This has taken way longer than I thought it would.
Well, this is a two-parter.
Well, guess probably.
You're gonna have to beat Spider Greg.
Yes, this is a sort of another puzzly sort of boss.
I like the puzzly sorts of boss. Oh, shoot his bum. It's red.
You have to close the door below him. And when you do that, he does a sort of bump attack that knocks rocks down from the ceiling. So if you open the door just as he's doing that, it brings him into pain range.
Pain range!
And watch out for his legs when they fly off.
Oh, do they hurt too?
Yes.
Ah, dick move, Kershaw.
It's an arse.
No, getting close. So yeah, like... How many times has someone said Shenmue 3 will never happen to you?
I don't know, I've never really taken an interest in Shenmue.
Oh, okay. Well, people have said that a lot around me, because, you know, we play, the people I hang out with have a similar game taste.
Well, I watched some videos of Shenmue 1, it looks like the most tedious game experience ever devised by man.
Well, again, for its time and place, there was a lot that was sort of new and radical to it. Because in a time when all of cutscenes were just sort of cutscenes, the idea of, you know, you can interact with a cutscene, you can push buttons and things happen, and sometimes if you do it right, you get like a new attack. And...
I keep fucking this up.
Yes, I wasn't going to point that out. I was going to leave that one for you.
Shit.
Uh-huh.
Why do I keep doing that?
I don't know. I can't solve this mystery.
Blonk. Correct my jumps.
I think it's because the grenade actually comes out a second, like there's a delay between push and grenade release. Good call. Oop, yeah. Even in death.
Phew, blimey.
Ping.
Hey.
Ooh. I think you're doing a good enough job with this shotgun. I don't think you really need to be grenading him at this point.
Oh, well, he started doing his thing. See, all the bosses in this game have the attack they gain when they're low on health.
Yeah. The secondary form.
Turns red, I believe is the term.
Oh, okay.
In TV trope land. Oh. Piddly piddly pantsy bum. The boss music in this game is made by Simon Loveridge and produced by Mark Lovegrove, who previously made the music of my previous games.
The spider only has six legs.
I think, in retrospect, perhaps there should have been music in the in-betweeny levels as well as the boss fights. Because otherwise the game sort of sounds a little bit dead, I think. Now that I'm a more experienced game developer.
With the presence of mind of a professional.
With commercial products out. Who's worked with, like, stores and...
Sold things. And I've worked with shops. Oop. And the shenanigans start.
Bloody shenanigans.
Maybe I'd, like... chance some grenades now. Are you able to jump on the rocks that come down?
Nope.
Nope. Who will win?
Oh. Shield doesn't protect from those. Well, that's the shield anyway.
Shields up! Shields up! Oh. If you just shot him too, like, probably had one shot left.
I just wanted to be safe. God damn it.
Okay, so what did the shield actually protect you from? Is ground blast?
Because
I couldn't quite see. I didn't see
actually,
what
I think
got
what,
you.
The only thing the shield does is just it sort of acts as a grenade explosion around you.
So it's a hurt box, so it
so
won't.
So if anything that would be killed by a grenade is killed by it.
I see. So it's not really.
So it doesn't protect you from anything like the rocks or the spider if you touch them.
Yeah. So it's not a Hail Mary kind of cheat shield.
No.
It's still a degree of tactical sort
perhaps
of use.
That's something that should have been fixed.
Maybe like a level 2 shield?
Well,
not now.
Now it's getting complicated.
Now you're just playing silly buggers. Haha, oh. Spider, I am tricking you. I am the king of spider tricks.
Yeah, he doesn't learn this, fella.
No.
Not the great cognitive power, Mr. Giant Spider.
Can you imagine that if Konami just came out and was just like, no, I'm just making pachinko machines. Fuck you, fuck your games, we make a lot of money doing this, go to
they done that?
But I mean more directly, I think there's still a little circumspect about it at the moment.
Right. Spider dead.
Achoo. I did read a thing once that said that like Microsoft's shareholders have there's like a big sort of camp in them that wish Microsoft would just abandon gaming.
Rebecca's dad's dead.
No!
This is sort of pivotal moment in the arcs of both spirit characters.
Daddy, no.
This is where Magnus starts to realize extreme methods are required, and Rebecca starts to realize she needs to be her own woman.
Yep.
No, you hear Magnus lampshades that by pointing out that Rebecca isn't crying for once. Because she is gaining strength through her compact with Derek. And now we have a tender moment where Derek is fatherly. And put a little joke, put a little gag on the end just so it doesn't get too serious all of a sudden.